Hello, hello everybody. Welcome to DNN After Dark. Can I just say, wow, I'm amazed by some of these costumes. You guys look fantastic. Thank you for all the folks that dressed up, and make sure to go and get your pictures taken. We're gonna get this party started right away with Jeff Hardy from Power DNN. What's better to do than to start the party off by giving away a car? Jeff, come on up on stage.
I was going to be going first. Can you all hear me all right? Perfect. Well, first of all, before we get going, I got to say, this is my first DNN World, and I think it's been a fabulous event. So everyone at DNN Corp put this together and spent all of the sponsors' money so well. I think they all deserve a wonderful round of applause, shall we? That's wonderful. Okay, now, I've got a list. Now, it looks like... Okay, there's 378 and a half people in the room, and I got about 200 names in the list. Who stopped by the Power DNN booth and registered for the giveaway? One of them's lucky. All right, let's figure this out. So what I've done is all of those names were entered in our database, and we're going to select one at random. Now, this is going to get hard. Where's Ellie Diem? Wonderful. Stay by. Stay close. We're going to bring the person up on stage, and then we're going to present them with some choices. It'll be kind of fun. All right. Anybody got a drum roll? Perfect. All right. Bruce Chapman.
Oh, no.
You're kidding me.
I'm not kidding you. Okay, now Bruce, first of all, you are now hated by 199 people.
Not much has changed.
Okay. Ellie, would you please come here?
Does anyone know anything about mobile development? Because someone can give my presentation tomorrow.
Do you have the handheld mic? Do you have the handheld?
So here's the choice. Thank you. So here's the choice. It is a one-day rental of a fine Italian blonde beauty sitting in the parking lot right now. The type of car that even a .NET Nuke developer could get a date in. Or $1,000 cash. Now, there's a few things that Bruce... Yeah. I'm gonna let you help him. You're all gonna have an opportunity to help him, but he has to know some things. I've written a 17-page liability indemnification waiver, which will make him responsible for any damage that may or may not occur on the said vehicle. And does that may or may not affect your decision? But this may also affect your decision. So, what I would like to have is a round of applause. Who thinks he should take the car?
Yeah, car.
Not bad. Of course, none of them are your family. None of them need a college education. Heck, probably most of them don't have one themselves. But, it's a damn fine automobile. So who thinks that Bruce should take the $1,000 cash? Wow. They don't like you either. That's right. So now, as a side incentive, if he doesn't take the car, I get to drive it.
For the rest of the night, right?
I know.
But I don't want that to influence your decision at all either. So, Bruce, which will it be? Lamborghini?
Wow.
I'll still give you a ride in it.
It's the car.
It's the car? He's taking the car!
Yay!
Now, all right, that said, for the employees of the hotel, can I hear from all the bartenders, please? Bruce is cut off for the remainder of the evening.
Oh.
Congratulations, Bruce. Thank you, Dean N. We appreciate it. See you all next year.
Thanks, Jeff.
Thank you.
Congratulations. I was about to say, if he took the money, it would have been drinks on Bruce. So next up, we have Bob Kruger, our Senior Vice President of Engineering. And Bob is going to recognize some of our international community members for localization and internationalization. Come on up, Bob.
Yay.
How about that costume?
Hey, first, I want to congratulate Bruce, but you're going to need the $1,000 to pay for the gas. The nature of things. Before I get going with the localization, I did want to clear up one item, though. My hero's name is The Flash, not The Flasher. Okay? There's a big difference. And in this costume, it's pretty difficult. So let me set the stage for you with a couple of tidbits of information. 8 releases since March, 402 files, close to 11,000 keys, almost 70,000 words, and nearly 473,000 characters. It's a lot of data. And as you know, at .NET Nuke, we build software incredibly fast. These guys have had to adhere to some really tight deadlines. They've given us great value. To add to that, it's not just about their English skills, but also about their profound knowledge of .NET Nuke. That's what makes the difference in having really, really great translations. On top of that, because they work so early with us in the process and we're in such constant contact, we get fantastic feedback. And we bring that early into the product, which helps us to do overall much better. So I thought today it would be worthwhile to take a moment and recognize their contributions. And so with the appreciation for helping to make the world tighter with localized .NET Nuke, I'd like to have each of them come up here and we'll take a group photo. And we have a little award for you. So starting off with BSI Informatique in Antunet, and that is Benoit Sorton. If you could come up here, please.
Yay.
Next, this graphic tech, and that's Vicente Massanas. DNN Werk, so Sebastian Leupold. Opsi Sarl, and that being Marco Parmesani. And Marco was unable to make it to Florida, so accepting the award on behalf of Marco. And then next, XS Expertise Center, and that's Rob Schurland, so helping to do Dutch. As you know, we do 5 languages, all concurrently, along with English. And a lot of this also wouldn't have been possible without help from Peter Donker to help coordinate the localization.
Peter.
So for each of you, we have a nice award here.
Thank you.
A little memento.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. So thank you guys very much. when we're getting closer and get a photo. Thank you. Thanks,
thank
guys.
You, Bob. Very kind of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very
nice.
Yeah. Thank you. Congratulations.
You have to click for Marco.
Okay. So next up, we have Clark Kent, captain of the community, and also Superman. He's got a lot of things to give away, so I'll hand it over to him. You get your clicker right there.
Yours is right here.
Okay, a bunch of boxes for travel. Use this one.
Okay. Use that
one?
Okay.
Here
we go.
Hands are going to be full.
I'll help you.
Hello. All right. These are really no help at all. Neither is that. Okay. So, you're wondering why I'm standing up here. It's because I do have a lot of things to give away, because there are a lot of people who deserve recognition in this community. And so, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to talk about a program that's new this year, just for a minute, and that is something called Most Valuable Person. Okay, so for the first year ever, we're going to award MVPs, all right? Let's hear it for MVPs. As you heard this morning, we've been doing this for 10 years, and that's a long time. So frankly, I think anybody who's still around is an MVP in my book. But over that 10 years, the core team has served us very well.
Bring your mic up.
Core team has served us very well. But as we have developed as a company, it's become increasingly difficult to participate in the same way, and yet we have guys out there just doing so much all the time that we really felt it was time now to make that transition and say there's some special people we need to point out. We're going to introduce 10 of them tonight, and the goal is to introduce another 10 of them in the spring, and this is a program we'll continue to build over time. But without further ado, I would like to go ahead and tell you what these guys do. In addition to product development, they do community support, platform evangelism, open source contribution, and on-site participation. Those are the four general categories that we've looked at for these folks. We went out, we surveyed the community, we had people nominate to suggest who was a DNN superhero, if you will, or MVP to them. And we got a lot of feedback. In a pretty short period of time, we got about 30 guys submitted. And it was a really laborious decision to sit down and go through them all and say, man, look at all the stuff they do. I'll tell you, it was truly enlightening, actually, to see what some of these guys are doing, because it's easy to forget and overlook, so we want to recognize them tonight. So, without further ado, my clicker. Yeah. Let's have you up on the stage one at a time, please. Brian Dukes from Engage Software.
Yay, Brian!
Brian has the distinction of having the highest reputation in the community exchange by far. So thank you, Brian. Congratulations. There's your award. You can look at the camera. All right. And a nice little gift for you as well. So limited edition. Thanks, bud. Appreciate your service.
And yeah, we're going to take a group picture.
Just hang on next on the docket, these are in alphabetical order, by the way. Brandon Haynes. Among many other things that Brandon does, Brandon is the only member of our security response team who doesn't actually work for DNN Corp, and we appreciate all of his expertise. So thank you, Brandon. Yep. All right. Nope, don't run away.
Don't
there you go,
away.
DNN MVP. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Hang out on stage for a minute. We're going to get a group photo.
Next, alphabetical order, Clint Patterson.
Clint! Woo!
You all know that Clint does a ton, but I'll tell you the thing he does that warms my heart the most. Clint
Where's
probably
your costume,
has
Clint?
One of the biggest hearts for education around here that anybody does. And I love a guy that takes his time out for students. So, Clint, thanks, brother. You are an MVP.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hey, don't run off. There you go.
Hang on.
Next, Ernst Peter Tominga. Ernst Peter, you do so much, man. You keep you keep me feeling old, man. I don't know how you do it.
I don't know either.
The events module, the FAQ module, a whole bunch of community contribution, and a gold partner to boot.
Yeah.
So thank you for your example. Appreciate it. There you go, bud.
Thank you very much.
All right. Our next MVP is the only one who's not here. We have 9 of 10 tonight, but I'd like to recognize Ingo Herbota. Ingo is the guy behind 6 different projects in our open source forge, including the CK editor provider, Tag Cloud, URL Shorty, a bunch of those. The guy has given 26 releases of software on his own this year. So Ingo, in Germany, thanks, man. Next, Mitchell Sellers. Where are you, Mitchell? There he is. Among the other distinctions Mitchell could get would probably be the most traveled user group speaker in the history of .NET Nuke, yeah. I'm guessing. All right, there you go, bud.
Thank you.
Got a bag for you? Thanks, Mitchell. All right. Couple more. Could still be you. Peter Donker. Oh. Thanks, Peter. If it has anything to do with languages, Peter does it. If it has anything to do with modules, Peter has done it. If it's got anything to do with document management, Peter knows about it. And if it's got anything to do with web services, he's teaching about it here. So thanks, Peter.
Thanks.
No, sorry. Nice try, Brad.
If you keep winning, you might be back up. We need a costume.
Coming up next, Stefan Kallman. There you go, Stefan.
Thank you.
A little handshake, brother. Thank you. You guys all know Stefan because of Form and List, more than likely. But I just would like to take just a moment. I've known Stefan for almost 10 years, and this is the first time we've met face-to-face. I love this about .NET Nuke. English is your second language, third? Fourth? And yet, Stefan is always at every meeting. He is always contributing to everything. He's very proactive, and if I had to give him a superhero name tonight, despite lack of costume, it'd be The Rock. So, couple more here. Vishen Masanas. Right here. There you go. Thanks, man. All right.
Ooh. I got one for him?
Yeah, you got it? Mm-hmm. Thanks. I should let you do that.
Carol Merrill.
All right, next. One more. Now, this one, I'll take a little special pleasure in giving. This is another one of those guys I've known for a super long time. And every time you start feeling like a superhero yourself, you know, you have a good day at work and you get a lot done. You know, you stay a little later and you do a few extra things. You log in, you maybe answer some questions and do something. There's one guy that always makes you feel like, I don't know, like you can't win, because he's there. He's omnipresent. And so I'd like to say thank you and congratulations on being an MVP to Sebastian Leopold.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks, Sebastian.
Thank you.
Say thank you to all of our MVPs for fall 2012.
Can you get a group photo?
I think we can get a group photo here, yeah. Half of you maybe down in front? Yeah, maybe half down in front. Yeah, hold your words up. Thanks again, fellas. Well earned. Okay. I get to talk at you for a couple more minutes. All right. What a contest year we've had, haven't we? One other contest. This year's Site of the Year. Okay, this year we went looking for Site of the Year contest. We're always looking for new tools. And we decided to run the contest on Facebook this year. And so we opened up and asked for submissions. And man, they started coming in. We had 71 submissions for Site of the Year this year. We had 6,000 votes cast. Narrowed it down to just a few entries, and from those we were able to, with much deliberation, make three choices in three categories. And so the first one, yes.
Do we know where fake?
I'm not really normally known for not being loud enough. I apologize.
Okay.
So the first one in the category for nonprofit. And when I present this, if you're associated with the website, please just come on up here. Not just whoever submitted the entry, but you, your whole team. Come on up. Engage Software for Yellowstone Country. Visit Yellowstone Country. Come on up. Come on, you guys. Anthony Overkamp, Oliver Hein, Henry Keenom, Jason Stone, Brian Dukes. All right, Engage, and for the whole team, you guys all get to fight over this one nice Nexus 7. So,
thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
All right. Yellowstone Country. Nice job, fellas. All right, two more categories to go. The next one for business. Aero Designs, Hilton Grand Vacations. Henry Tavares, Ralph Williams, Sabrina Waugh, Ryan Morgan, Randy Beasley, and Seth Shepard.
Is anyone here from Hilton as well?
For web
Randy?
And mobile. Come on up.
Randy, you here?
Congratulations. We'll get a photo. Appreciate it. All right. This is the last one. We saved the personal one for last. So I think this may be the first time we've had so few entries in the personal category. It's a great testimony to what you guys are doing with .NET Nuke, because we've got a lot of businesses and a lot of organizations out there using it. So we had a few entries in the personal category, but one kind of clearly stood out above the rest, and surely the votes proved that out. So give a warm congratulations to Lee Wise, who is pretty much awesome.
Woo! Nice.
I bow to the awesomeness, Lee.
I need the number.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot.
Oh, no.
No warranty, by the
gorilla
way.
Gorilla hands.
Thanks.
Thanks, Scott. Good job. Okay, next up, we've got the Superfan Award. Before we give out the award, though, I want to talk a little bit about last year. So last year at the conference, we launched 6.1 in our mobile functionality. And after that, we created a fictitious bike company called Awesome Cycles as an example of how to build great websites. And with Awesome Cycles came these two guys, Chris and Will. And along the way, Chris and Will learned how to build their website, deploy it on mobile sites, and build a community as well. And a little bit later on, they discovered DNN World. And finally, we posed the question, will they make it to DNN World? So ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to introduce the real Chris and Will.
Out into nothing, gonna leave this
So Chris and Will really did want to skydive into the event, but the city of Orlando and the FAA wouldn't allow it, so they decided, but they did practice a lot. This is them practicing. I don't think they ever made it out of indoor skydiving, but you gotta give them some credit for trying. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring up the real Chris and Will. Where are they? Oh, hey, wait a minute. Will Morganwick, Chris Patera, what are you guys doing here?
We just want to set the record straight that the real Chris and Will are right here. Right? That's it.
And why are you guys the real Chris and Will?
Right.
Uh-oh, what's that? It may be a battle of the Chris and Wills. I think you guys better get out of here. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, the real Chris and Will. Will, what do you have there?
Well, who are those other guys?
I don't know, I think they were imposters. You scared them away.
Whatever. So I have the world's only awesome cycle.
Woo! Chris, what do you have?
I got the shaft.
What happened? Why don't you have an awesome cycle?
Not really sure. I had a bike all lined up, and then this showed up.
Okay, I guess he wouldn't make you one. And what else are you guys wearing?
These are the Awesome Cycles .NET Nuke Cycling Kits, part of the prizes for the Superfan Contest.
That's great. So they win. Second place wins the outfit?
And that's third right. Place? Third place gets the helmet, and first place gets it all.
Okay. Well, I'll hand it over to you, and you can hand out the awards.
All right, one light.
Oh, here's your clicker.
Are we on?
Yep.
Slightly used outfit.
All right. So if you're not familiar with the Superfan Contest, we have this contest now for the second year. People submit certain submissions to prove that they are the world's superfan of .NET Nuke. So we've had quite a few entries for the last couple years, some really great ones. We've had some videos. We've had some girly boys in the front row over here waving at me. Nice. So some rap videos and so on. This year, we had some really great entries. So we had comic strips, we had videos once again. So a lot of things going on here. And so we really appreciate all this participation from the community to show that you're the super fan. We especially appreciate everybody that was participating in the voting. There's a lot of competition with the voting, and especially online and things like that. All right. So without further ado, we're going to start naming the winners. So the first one is third place. Now, I've known this person for a very long time. Hopefully they're happy that they're at least in the top three. But this person, they're not always doing .NET Nuke. Okay, he already knows. Ryan Morgan, third place, Superfan Contest.
Good job, man. Put it on.
So I got a speech. Hey.
So I'd like to keep the music up.
Okay.
I love you, man. I heart you. Oh, there you go. So, very appropriate, considering.
Stay up here. We're staying up?
Huh? No, no, no. Oh, okay. No, he's not staying up. All right.
I'll stay up.
No, we just wanted to give you the impression that we wanted you up here longer. Oh, there's the thing. All right. Okay, so next, the second place. The second place was very fun. Loved that this person participated. They didn't participate in the last Superfan, and this has really boosted a lot of activity for this person and their friends. A lot of activity in trying to garner votes and trying to get things going with the community. We have a lot of new registrations and things. And the great thing about it is that it was a great video. So it was, oh, it's not her. Sorry. It wasn't her. It was more like that. Kara Plouffe, second place. You want to take the jersey out? It better be your size.
It's a half.
Oh, we need to zip that up.
I was trying to let her put it on.
Oh, you're going to have her put her. No.
No.
Congratulations. Do you want to do what Ryan did? Do you want to take the mic?
No?
That's true. Who wants to hear her sing the song?
Yay! Woo! Yay!
Aww. All right, get the jersey
sing
back.
With you.
All right. So next, the official superfan of 2012. This person doesn't really need an introduction. I think we all happen to know who this person is. They do a lot. They do a lot. You know, from different videos to, you know, secret spy videos to, you know, trying to get people hablar, right?
Killing Bambi.
Killing Bambi. That's true. That's true. He's a hunter. He's a hunter. So this particular superfan, what they did, they basically did a video resume of all the things they've been doing over the past year. And I can't say enough how much I appreciate all the work that he does in evangelism. And you know, the Superman video is just a taste of what he does. It's Clint Patterson.
Clint. Yay.
You deserve the DNN Superman.
Hold the button.
You inspire me.
So Clint gets the hit, he gets the helmet, he gets the world's only off-cycle.
What do y'all think of when you think about a new superfan? What I think of is hunting, fishing, Espanol, community, football, redneck, and family. .net new. Clint Patterson, superfan.
Should fit. Helmet on.
Now, real quick. Oh, you're gonna put the helmet
you
on?
You didn't order a big enough helmet.
That's not the, we can get you a large, dude. There's a large in the back. I didn't know your dome was that big. Congratulations. Thank you, Clint. Thank you. All right. So I have one more thing. Where is Eric C. Sharp? VB. Eric VB. Eric VB has something. Is that it? Where is it? Don't tell me it's on. Oh, no, not the tattoo. Eric VB has a mankini. Anybody know what a mankini is? If the real Borat wants to disclose who they are, he has a mankini for you. Anybody?
I don't know if that's an incentive.
All right.
Maybe later.
All right, that's it for the superfans. Thank you, everybody, for participating. Thank you for being superfans. Thank you for all the things that you do throughout the year. Thank you for evangelizing. Thank you for just being excited, being emotional, and loving the product as much as people like we do. Thank you.
Okay, for our last event of the evening, we're going to have our costume contest. And I'm going to call up the six finalists that our spies in the audience have selected. So if your number is called, come up on stage, and the winner is going to win this lovely Xbox here. Okay. So 742. We have 742. All right. It's Captain America. 727. Do I have 727? Your number's on your back. Get someone to look at your back. Yes, it's Dog the Bounty Hunter. Dog, what does it say? I'll shake your hand.
DNN Borat.
DNN Borat. He's on the hunt. Okay, we're all on the hunt. 713. We have 713. Oh, it's Batman. That's great. Okay. 763. 763. Ah, it's the Flash. Another great costume. 710. 710. Do I hear to see a 710? Oh, there we go. Clark Kent. And the last one is 779. Who's 779? All right, okay. So, can you guys all take a step forward? Now, we're gonna do this by applause. I'm gonna go put my hand over each person's head. You can only vote for one person, and we're gonna eliminate the first candidate. All right, Eric C. Sharp. Bob the Flash. Yes. Okay, it's pretty good, pretty good. Captain America. Wow, oh, that's pretty good. Dog the Bounty Hunter. That's very good. Batman. Yeah. Clark Kent. Captain Kent. Yeah, who do we think it is? You know, I think we eliminated Batman, unfortunately. Okay. And the Flash. We're gonna take two off right now. Okay, so one more time, we're gonna go through. Eric VB. All right, it's good. Chad Nash. Dog. Clark Kent. Oh, sorry. He's incredible. Okay.
Can you do a headstand?
Can you do a headstand?
Yeah.
This may be cheating.
People.
This could end badly. Beautiful dismount. Okay, Chad Nash. Dog. Bucket. Okay, I think we have a winner. Dog is our winner. Chad is number two. Clark Kent, number three. Dog, this is your prize. And here's the funny thing. We've got bobbleheads for the second and third place winner. So you get Barack Obama. And you get Captain Community. Okay, let's give him another round of applause. Okay, thank you everybody. That ends our on-stage activities. Enjoy the party, have some drinks, eat up.